Hey guys, and welcome back to the channel. So today we're doing another film review, and we're going to be doing the one and only Ivan, which is an upcoming Disney Plus film. When did it come out?
August, I think.
I think it's August.
Yeah.
I'll pop in the exact date, like here.
The trailer literally dropped 3 days ago.
Yep, so it is brand new. So obviously if you do like this video, don't forget to hit a thumbs up and smash it, subscribe, and let's get straight into it.
Welcome to your new home.
We're here rolling.
What are you looking at, huh? Your papa.
Looking at his daddy.
Let's give him a great show, okay?
The one and only.
Why do they want an angry gorilla anyway?
You're a silverback. He terrifies humans.
You're not terrifying. Who's that?
My sister.
Where's your sister now?
I don't remember.
Memories never leave us. They just get out of reach.
Whoa. Did you draw all these?
A gorilla.
Who draws?
What is it? Don't tell me.
It's a lonely haystack on a late summer day.
It's a beetle.
Can you tell me a story?
Once there was a baby elephant who was smart and brave, and she needed to live in the wild where she could be free.
Ivan!
Does the baby elephant get to be free?
Is clearly a sign he wants to be free.
What about Mac? He's taken care of me my whole life.
We're family. We're in this together.
For one and only, Ivan!
I'll just cross the road then.
Why would you cross the road?
To get to the other side.
God, I was not expecting that.
That looks amazing.
Like, I was not expecting it to be anything like that. I'm actually speechless.
That looks so good.
The graphics and everything, like, look insane. The music, even to start off with, like, I love that song so much. Yeah. Like, we listen to that all the time. It's got some amazing actors in it.
Yeah.
Like,
and it's the fact that it's based on a true story. Before we like actually get into like really what we thought of it, we'll just say the director of this is Thea Sharrock. I'm not sure how you say that. The writers are Mike White, which is he done the screenplay, and Catherine Applegate done the book. And the stars in it are Philippa Sue, Sam Rockwell, Angelina Jolie.
Danny DeVito does the voice.
Does he? That's the only... you can get
Bryan Cranston. The main guy in it.
I don't know why they've got the names there, but
there's a lot of
people in it. A lot of known people.
Yeah.
But yeah, that looks incredible. Mm-hmm. So it is like based on a true story of this gorilla that I think it like basically teams up with the elephant to try and get out of captivity.
Right.
I believe.
I didn't get that from... Well, I guess I did. You can tell that he's trying to be free.
Yeah, from that they were like dreaming of being free. But I think from what I've read about it is they tried to escape or they tried to get out. I'm not sure if that actually happens. But.
Oh, it just looks so adorable. And it was just, there was little funny bits in it and it just looks so realistic. And there looks like there's a lot of emotion in this film.
Yeah.
And I think that's going to be enhanced by the fact that it's based on a true story. I love anything 100%. That's based on reality.
So. And I think it's good, like, because they could have either done it where, like, the gorilla, like, all the animals don't actually talk. But because they've given them all voices and it looks like they're going to have all completely different characters as well. Like, at the end where, like, they're all on the road and the chicken. It's like, why are you going to cross the road? Like, to get the other side. Like, it's obviously going to be funny as well as a really, like,
emotional.
Emotional gripping. Story, yeah.
Yeah, I think I'm actually really excited for this. I feel like this is something I'd actually have really liked to have seen in the cinema. I feel like the visuals are going to be so great on it, and I really, really hope that, like, I don't know if it's going to be... Does Disney Plus do 4K stuff? We've got 4K telly. Yes.
Yeah, it does.
So we might be able to watch it in 4K, which, if we can, then I think.
Because, obviously, there's a lot of, is it CGI and things like that that's in this? I think the sort of colours and, like, especially for, the gorilla.
Yeah.
His, like, hairs and everything. Like, the detail in these kind of films is unreal.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Like, so even just to watch it with no sound, and it's just like an eye explosion.
It's just the fact that it makes... they look so realistic next to the humans who are actually real, and that it's so seamless.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, we say it every time, Disney smash it out the park with this. Their animation skills are unbelievable.
Yeah.
I
think, like, there are people that... Like when they do the remakes of films, they prefer it to be more cartoony.
Mm-hmm.
But, I think just the sort of how advanced, like, it is now, and how, like, it looks real. Like, it's to the point where you can't tell if it's real or fake anymore half the time.
Yeah.
I think that's amazing.
You've really got to appreciate the skill that goes into that. Even if it's not your cup of tea and you prefer the film to be in more, like, old-school cartoony style, I think most people can appreciate the work and skill that goes into that.
Yeah.
One thing I want to mention before I forget is right at the end, like, the shopping centre thing was called Big Top. Right. It was like Big Top Shopping Centre, and then Big Top in Dumbo, Big Top Circus. Am I being really mad?
The film.
They were watching Robin Hood. Oh my god! Number one old school favourite, Robin Hood. That was really cute.
Yeah.
But yeah, Big Top, and then that reminded me of Magic Kingdom and that section of Magic Kingdom. So my brain's just, like, Disney-fied, like, everywhere.
They're so good. Like, when they make their trailers, they're so jam-packed with things. Mm-hmm. Like, we're going to have to re-watch that after this, just to sort of take in more, because you see so many little bits that are, like, from other films, like that.
Mm-hmm.
Like, oh, there's just so much to take in.
The artwork as well on the poster is beautiful. We're looking at it right now. I'll put a picture up. Yeah. But the colours on that and the silhouettes are really... I can't stop looking at it. It keeps drawing me in. And I'm really excited to see what they do with the landscapes and the nature in this film. That's one thing they do really well. Mm-hmm. If you think when we look at the Jungle Book remake... That wasn't a personal favourite, but the Lion King remake, the scenery in that is unbelievable, and I feel like it's going to be very similar with this film.
Yeah, definitely. So the sort of genres that they've put this film under is obviously animation, adventure, comedy, drama, family and fantasy.
It's got everything.
So I think it does, like, you can easily see that it's all of that, because they've, like, they're going on an adventure, you know, trying to get out of captivity and, like, into the free world, kind of, for them, into the wild, whatever. And obviously he's drawing, like, they make a joke about it being, like, hay and sun or something like that. And he's like, it's meant to be a beetle. And, like, the chicken at the end, like I said. So you've got that, like, comedic kind of effect.
Yeah, that's great. And I think it's nice as well that even though it is, like, a 2.5 minute trailer, I still don't feel like they've given too much away about the film.
Not at all.
I really hate it when you watch a trailer and then you watch the film and there's basically nothing else that happens than what they've shown you in the trailer. They're the best bits of the film. So I am really excited to see what else happens.
I think the music really makes it as well. Because obviously at the beginning it's all like a jolly song, like, and you get into it. But then as it gets into, like, the sort of, I guess, like, the core of the story, would you call it that? Like, the music changes and you get more, like, sort of, like...
drama.
Yeah.
Intensity.
Yeah. It intensifies. And, like, you're proper there, like proper pulls you in. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, I know what you mean. Like, it's gripping.
Yeah. It's just a really gripping trailer. By the end of it, you're like, whoa, like, I need to see that.
Yeah, no, to be fair, like, I've, like, relaxed a bit now because I'm more focused on, obviously, the video. But that first 5 seconds after watching that trailer, I was just like... It was not what I was expecting at all. And I am really, really excited. I'm definitely glad that we've sat and watched this trailer, because otherwise we'd have probably just ignored it.
Yeah, well, I mean, until like just the other day when the trailer came out, we didn't know it was a thing.
No.
Like, I'm pretty sure it was announced before that. Obviously, it might the trailer have been, wasn't out.
Yeah. I mean, there's so many announcements of Disney Plus at the moment, and then you never know which is American and which is in England. So, yeah, I'm excited for this one.
So that is going to be our little like sort of reaction slash review of the trailer. If you have watched it or you're going to rewatch it and react yourself, let us know down below. Let us know what you think.
Yeah.
And if you want to watch it, and let us know if you prefer like the more realistic sort of CGI like that or the more. It's like cartoon effect.
I don't think I have a preference. I enjoy like both.
I think for a film like this, this is perfect. Mm-hmm. Like, and I think they do choose the right thing, like in each film. But yeah, anyway, let us know. And if you have liked the video, hit a big thumbs up and smash the subscribe down below, because we will be doing many more in the future.
Yeah.
And we will see you soon.
Bye. Mwah.